Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new around here. My name is Brittany. Today is classroom setup day 3. This is the day that I've been waiting for with much anticipation. This is the day where we decorate the classroom. So I really tried to organize myself this year, and on day 1, we just got furniture placed where it needed to go. Day 2 in the classroom was all the finer details, organizing, tossing stuff out, that sort of thing. And I waited for day 3 today to be able to decorate the classroom. And it's been a little hard to wait, so I'm very excited. So excited, in fact, that I filmed day 2 just yesterday. So it hasn't been very long since I was last here in my classroom, but we are back again today. Also, if you are new around here, you may not already know that I am a 4th grade teacher in Maine. I'm going into my 13th year as a teacher. I previously taught 6th grade for 9 years, and now this will be my 4th year in 4th grade. Brandon is already off on a task over to my left. You can probably tell that Brandon's doing something because over my shoulder you can see some of my decorations bouncing around. He is actively trying to rehang that wire that fell down in the spring when we were closing up the classroom. And if you tuned in for classroom setup day 2, then you will have seen some of the decorations that we are going to be putting all around the classroom today. I am super excited about getting the decorating going, so let's dive in. Our wire has been rehung. Brandon is adjusting the decoration that was already on it. And I am going to get over here and open up these beautiful lanterns. We have 2 packages of them, varying sizes, very excited about that. All of the other lanterns that I have in my room are only a couple of different sizes, and I think we have smaller ones here than we've ever had before. And then we also have some fans. You can tell that I'm going with the rainbow theme. It's been my theme for a couple of years now, and I really like it, so I'm gonna stick to it. I also have some beautiful sets of LED lighting, and I'm not sure yet where I want to put these, but they are something that I will also be considering putting up today. We'll see if we get to this part. I'm mostly concerned with getting these decorations up because having Brandon here to help with that, since he is able to go on the ladder and be taller than me, is really helpful. This is something that I probably won't be hanging too high, I don't think. I don't know, maybe. Anyway, we have that set of string lights as well as this set. So we are definitely going to be adding some fun lighting to the classroom. These are Velcro dots, which not really decorating related, but anyway, we have them. And then my label maker. So when we first arrived here, I realized I'd forgotten my key to get into the classroom, and it kind of worked out because I had to run home and grab that. And while I was grabbing the key, I also grabbed enough batteries to be able to put them in my label maker that I got with my classroom budget this year. So excited about the label maker. So I am prepared to label all the things today, and I am just thrilled about that. And then I'm going to try to find a place for this pencil parking. Oh dear. Oh, I think I ordered 2 of them. Yes, I did, because I have 2 different classes and 1 pencil parking did not have enough space for all of the students I'll have amongst the 2 classes. So good, I got both of them. I'm thankful for that, but that means I need to find a place to put both of them. I may actually repurpose this door and take this down and put these up there. I think that's a good idea. Just thought of that in the moment, and I think that's what I'm going to do. All right, let's dive in. Ooh, these fans come in various sizes too. Oh my gosh. Our classroom is going to be dripping in adorableness. Whoa, what is happening here? I think I am mildly confused. Oh, okay. Let's look at the instructions on the side of the package. All right, I was not supposed to take that string off, it seems. Whoops-a-daisy. Okay, this one, we're gonna set off to the side until I have figured these out. I'm still not sure. Carefully pull, leave it tied, it seems. This isn't entirely tied. Am I supposed to actually tie it? Or is this just supposed to stay just like this, and I'm just supposed to pull? Okay, I think I'm just supposed to do this. I do not understand. Lordy pants, Brinny Bear. It's all poofed, but I just pulled the string out. Oh, Lordy. Okay, so the puffles are taking a lot longer than anticipated.
Puffles?
Puffles, that's what we're calling them now. So I'm gonna pause on the puffles because this is a lot It's a lot of puffles. We might be puffling at home, and we're going to move on to the lanterns, which take a lot less time to assemblage. Let's go same color even in case there's any variation. So apparently we're racing. We each have the same size one here. Ready? Go.
Does it count if they rip?
Yes.
My
like,
thing.
If they rip, then you get no points. You automatically lose. Yep, DQ'd. Done. For anyone that can't see, Brandon is still over here on the struggle bus, and Brittany is 100% done.
No.
I won. When we are done, it's going to look like Rapunzel lives here. That's what I told Brandon. He says, maybe I have too many. I said, absolutely not. I know that I said less is more in my last classroom vlog, but less is not more when it comes to beautiful lanterns that I want to hang about my classroom. Brandon is way up there in the corner. He's waiting for me to pass him a couple of lanterns. So we're gonna get to it. Oh my goodness. This is, both bags have been popped open at this point. We did put a little cluster of three there, small one, cluster of three there as well, but otherwise we haven't added any new ones. So the new ones are really starting to go up right about now. Yep, lantern explosion. Brandon just descended from hanging the very last lantern, which was that hot pink one up there. So let's take a little look around the room, a little tour, if we shall. This is what we've got along the very top of the room. We had some here before, but it's just a lot more full now. Feels better. I added a couple around this B over here. Just like the way that looks. Added that yellow one in the corner. We did add a couple of hanging ones and more toward the back portion of the room here. So that's what our lanterns are looking like. You also saw that I got the pencil parking hung up. Oh, I love these little lanterns. They're just fun. They're just a fun pop of color, fun little something to bring some interest into the classroom. I love that we've been able to hang them in varying locations, various places. Oh, I love them. Now, as for these guys, they're not proving to be as easy to assemble as I was thinking. I think that this is actually supposed to be the front side, but that's not looking so hot to me, so I opted to consider this the front. And then this would look very nice on a wall or wherever, so I think we will get to hanging them up, but it's going to take some time to fluff them, so I'm undetermined if we are doing that tonight or if we are going to fluff at home and bring them back and hang them on a different day. Plans have been devised for the lighting. We're going to put one section of the light all around the board. I previously had the like white Christmas lights up around the board. Here they are on the floor. We took down three strings, and the idea is that this one here dies right about there, and that is not the end of the string. There's all that that's just not lit up. So we're gonna replace that one and then keep running it, hopefully to just about the end of this number line here. And that's what we've got going on. It's taken a little while to get to this point already because we had to figure out wiring, where to plug everything in, where to start the lights, the new lights, how to best utilize the previous lights, all the things. But that is the plan. That's what we're getting up to now. I will check back in with you when we make some more progress. That is a long string of lights. It's the lights that never end. We were able to go 2.5 times. Okay, well, let me rephrase that. We were able to circle the board 2 entire times, including up and down in the middle. Once we got to the completion of the second wrapping, we were able to go about to there-ish on top as well. You can kind of see where it's glowing up above, and then it's not on this half. So that's what we've got going on. It looks gorgeous. Let's turn off these big overhead lights so we can get a better... Ooh, I'm extra excited because I am going to be able to change the color of these lights to match the holidays, and that feels really fun. So that's what we've got going on around the board now, and I am loving it. Now we need to get these lights attached to that string and keep them going around the rest of the classroom. Consensus is I'm going to take these home and we're going to fluff those at home. Also, I did not get to, oh, my label maker is now over there. I did not get to labeling anything today, and that's okay, because what that means is that you guys are going to get a part 2 to day 3 setup. I'll probably just call it classroom setup day 4. Wasn't thinking I was going to need a day 4, but really pleased with the changes that we've been able to get done today in the last couple hours that we've been here. So I'm happy to come back and do a day four at some point. Look at the beautiful lighting all around the upper portion of the room, and it doesn't end now. Used to end, and we had a gap from about right there to about there, and now it goes all the way around the entire classroom with no gaps. And then we have a variety of lamps. This is the gentle lighting vibe that I like to go with when the kids are here during the school year. That lamp needs 3 more bulbs out of 5. You might not believe it because it's already so bright. That adds so much light to this back corner of the room. Then we have some lamps over in this corner and also over here by the TV. This one also needs a bulb, and then it's going to illuminate that corner a little bit better. And then I've already showed you the board, but oh, you should see it again because it's crisp, it's clean, it's beautiful, and I'm in love. So we have made some great changes. I'm loving the additional lanterns we got hung and the lighting changes that we were able to make. So what we will work on when we come back on another day is labeling all the things with our beautiful label maker. Still very excited for that. So labeling all the things, as well as Velcro dotting anything that I feel needs a Velcro dots. Look at all the Velcro dots we have. I am so excited. I opened the package. I think there's 500. And then fluffing those things at home. And then we still have another set of lights. I think this is probably about another 100 feet, and I just don't know yet where I want to put them. I'm going to continue to think on that. It's a great problem to have that I don't know where to put them, so I'm not at all complaining, but because it's so long, it needs to be somewhere where I can utilize all of them and still have it look nice and not just like I had a ton of extra lights and then sloppily tried to make use of them. So that's what's going to be going on the next time we come back to do the decorating. Here's what we have going on when you enter the classroom. It's so beautiful. It's so peaceful and beautiful, calming. I love being in this space, and that is what I was striving for, because if I love being in this space, then that inspires my students to also love being in this space. I added this bar light over here. This was a gift from a student and their family last year, and I really like it up there on that shelf. I got to thinking, it doesn't have to be on the floor, so I decided to put it up there next to the TV. I won't always have it on alternating colors like that, but for right now, I'm enjoying it. It could get distracting for some students, so it can be on solid colors. And then if you span along this portion of the classroom, everything just feels cozy. And that is all that I was aiming for. Cozy, safe, happy. And I feel like we have accomplished exactly that. It took time. We have been here for a couple of hours now. We arrived at 4 something and it's now 8 o'clock. So been here a while, but it was well worth it because, as I've said in some of my other videos, once the school year gets going, I don't have the time, the stamina to be able to come in and do these sorts of things. So now is the time to do it and get it all squared away before the school year actually starts. Thank you for joining me today. It's been a lot of fun. I'm feeling so content with everything that we've gotten accomplished. Every day that we've been here has been very well worth it, and we've made lots of progress in different areas on every single day. And wow, does it feel good, because this is our final day of July, so to have my classroom this ready to go and set up when it's not even August yet, I'm not sure I've ever had it in this kind of shape at this point in the year, this soon before school starts. So feeling really good. I'm hoping that's going to inspire me to just really enjoy the remainder of my time off and value my last few weeks of summer break. So as I mentioned, we are going to be back because we have a little more decorating to do. The decorating that remains includes one other set of lights, several fans that we're going to fluff at home, and then I'm going to label things. And I'm so excited for that. I can't believe that I was able to make myself wait today to label things, but I just really wanted to utilize Brandon while he was here with me, and I'm not sure if he'll be with me the next time that I come in. So getting those other lanterns up and the lights and things was something he was a huge help with. So very thankful to my husband, as always. He's such a good guy, and I am so lucky. So we're going to call it good for the evening. We're going to get the kids home. We ended up ordering pizza from a store that's 2 minutes down the road from my school, and they ate dinner here, so they're good to go when we get home. They've been in the pool already today, and we're going to call that a bath slash shower for the day because it's just too late for them to actually take a shower. So going to be one of those pool nights counts as a shower kind of thing. And that's a wrap for classroom setup day 3. And I'm excited to be able to say to you, I will see you for classroom setup day 4, which I wasn't expecting, but I'll take it. It's all a win to me because this sort of stuff feels really good to have everything so cohesive and so homey and cozy prior to the kids coming. Absolutely worth my time. So I'm looking forward to having a day 4, and I'm pretty glad it worked out that way. So thank you again for joining me today. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, please do so. I would love to have you here in my little corner of the internet. I'd love to see you back for Classroom Setup Day 4. And if you haven't caught Classroom Setups Day 1 and 2, please be sure to check those out. I put a lot of effort and love into my classroom, and I love sharing it with you guys. So again, thank you for being here. I can't wait to see you in the next one. Bye.